kailangan may specifics. So in line with that, actually may hinain ako sa inyo na basic momentum system, long only. Kumbaga, parang it's a guide for building a trading system, 'di ba? So syempre yung asset universe mo, US equities, index regime check mo, like ito yung ano, level 2 mo, no? Yung second process mo, which is looking at your indices. So for example, dito SPY and QS is above MA10 and MA20, and MA10 is greater than MA20. So ite-trade mo lang to kapag na-meet niya tong criteria na to. So gets ba? Then the market groups only look for setups in top leading or improving sector. So kunwari may market dashboard ka, pwede mong tingnan yung mga top leading sectors or yung mga nag-improve na sectors. So ganun. So dine-drill down mo siya top down. Next is yung rules and TA non-negotiables mo, or technical analysis non-negotiables mo. Technical non-negotiables. So dapat prices above MA20, MA50, price should be 20% above MA200, blah blah blah. Mid caps lang 10% below 20 day high, RSI above 40, blah blah blah. So kailangan meron kang non-negotiables dito. Then trade setups, ano yung mga trade setups? For example dito, base breakouts lang, quant pattern breakouts during markup phases. So yung mga quant patterns like flag, pennants, boxes. So yan lang yung mga iti-trade ng system na to. Then yung ranking rules, reward to risk, pwedeng nakadepende sa reward to risk, nakadepende sa volumes or sa RSI. Then risk management, 0.5 to 1% VaR per setup, 3 reward to risk ratio only na setups, and an allocation limit of 25% on a specific stock lang dapat. Then yung execution mo, data connection lost. Execution mo is a pre-market buy plus a bracket order. Then you only close your position at stop loss and TP only, 100% na closing of position. So gets naman, no? Very very straightforward system. So yun, may sistema na tayo. Ngayon, without a second brain or not without using tools, let's do this in real time, no? Just pure grunt work, showing the end-to-end process. Like, yung goal natin is to generate 1 to 2 trade ideas na nagko-qualify dito sa ano na to, sa system na to. So, firstly, tignan natin yung SPY and QS. So, ito yung SPY, or yung ETF ng S&P 500. First question, is it above MA20 and MA50? Ay, MA10 and MA20. Ito yung black line natin, MA10. Green line is MA20. So price is above it, and ayun lang, MA10 is not above MA20. So let's say MA10 is above MA20 na lang, no? Kasi hindi tayo gumawa ng mga offset dito. So sabihin natin, offset natin 3. Hindi pa rin, no? So let's say ganun na lang. And then yung Qs natin, it qualifies din naman yung QQQ natin. Price is above MA10, MA20, and MA10 is above MA20. So nasa momentum mode tayo. It's a buyer's market. So okay, iniisa-isa natin, 'di ba? So check, double check. Next step, let's look at the market groups. Ano yung malalakas na market groups? So in this watch list, meron na ako eh. So kung wala ka pa, medyo mahirap, iisa-isahin mo pa. So let's look at the themes and sectors. Ito yung SPY G, SPY V. Dito na lang tayo sa sectors na lang muna, no? Hindi na tayo magde-drill down dito sa subsectors. So let's look at XLY. Ano yung current market state niya? Is it bullish or bearish? So quite bearish, 'di ba? Yung consumer discretionary sector natin. Prices below MA20 and MA10, and prices below MA50. So cross X 'yun. Next is XLK, or yung tech tech sector natin. Prices above MA50, MA10, and MA20. Although MA10 and MA20 is below MA50, still quite considerably bullish pa din. So okay, sige, pasok yung XLK na yan in our parameters. Next, ito naman, yung XLC. XLC. Which is yung communication sector natin. So okay naman siya kasi MA10, prices above MA10, MA20, and MA50. So pasok tong dalawang to sa parameters natin, XLK and XLC. Ito, autopass yan, below MA50. Basta ganun, kailangan may rules ka. Only trade sectors above MA50. So XLP pass, XLB pass, pass or yung material sector, utilities lalo na, pass, autopass, industrials, pass din, XLF, pass, yung blue line natin yung MA50, ah. XLE, prices above MA50, okay, sige, pasok yung XLE, XLC, and XLK. So, ganun na lang natin tignan, XLRE, real estate, autopass, below MA50. So, na-drill down na natin yung mga sectors na gusto natin. XLK, XLC, and then XLE. So, yun yung top sectors natin or top market groups natin. So, yung next step natin is looking for stocks na pasok sa criteria na yan. So, isa-isayin natin siya. So, paano natin siya mahahanap? Sige. Pakita ko na lang din, etf.com. Punta tayo dito. etfdb.com. So for example, ito na lang. Let's say ang gusto nating i-trade is yung tech sector. Then ang gawin mo, punta ka diyan sa etfdb.com. Lagay mo lang XLK, then search for XLK, then click holdings. So makikita mo yung mga components ng sector na 'yon, 'di ba? Makikita mo yung components ng sector na 'yon. So, pinakamalaki is Apple, next Microsoft, then the rest. So, isa-isayin natin siya. And then, tignan natin ano yung pasok sa criteria na yun. So, for example, Apple. So, yung criteria natin, di ba? Prices above MA50 and MA20. Okay? Above MA50 and above MA20. Price 20% above SMA200. Sige, hanapin natin MA200. Lagay natin 200. 20% above. Yun lang, hindi siya pasok. 6% above lang. So, autopass tong Apple. Diba? So, hindi na siya pasok sa criteria natin. Next step is, or next stock is Microsoft. So, MA200, ito yung MA200 natin. Prices above MA20 naman. Although, yun nga, hindi nga din siya pasok nun sa criteria na to. 10% lang siya. So, isa-isayin mo siya. So, medyo tedious, di ba? Medyo tedious. Sige, tignan natin Nvidia. So, siguro naman, ito, pasok to. So, price relative to MA200, 30%. So, pasok na siya, di ba? Prices above MA50, double check natin. Okay, prices above MA50, MA20, above mid-caps or beyond mid-caps. Ano na to? Large or mega-cap na ata itong Nvidia. 0 to 10% below 20-day high. So, 0 to 10% below 20-day high. So, ano ba yung 20-day high natin? So, from the previous 20 days, ito yung highest point natin. So, 0 to 10% pasok naman. RSI above 40, pasok din. Nasa 55 level. 10% or more above 50-day low. Ito yung 50-day low natin. Pasok din siya. 10% or more above. So, okay. Nandito na tayo, di ba? Nandito na tayo. Ito, pwede na natin itong hanapan ng setup. Pasok na siya sa criteria natin or yung mga technical non-negotiables natin. So, okay. Hanapan natin siya ng technical setup. So, let's say, ang pwede nating setup dito is a base breakout eh. So pwedeng ang gawin mo, breakout at 481, yun yung aggressive entry mo, or ito yung pinaka ano mo, confirmatory entry mo at 500, a break above 500. Or pwede rin a break of this 20-day high or previous 5-day high. So pwedeng ganun yung entry point mo if a more aggressive momentum setup siya. So base breakouts or con patterns during markup phase. So under a markup phase ba siya? Yes, kasi near all-time high siya. Nag-break siya, nag-break above siya dito sa multi-year base na yan. So we are on a markup phase. So okay, generate na tayo ng trade idea. So ito yung entry point natin, stops natin, sige. Dito sa 450 level. Then targets natin, 1:1 na lang natin to, tong base na yan. So meron tayong 4.7:1 reward to risk ratio. So meron kang 7% risk in return of 33% or approximately 33%. So meron na tayong setup. Ranking rules natin. Okay, pasok na tayo dyan. Pasok siya sa volume criteria, whatever. Wala pa naman tayong ibang nakikitang stocks. Hindi pa tayo nakapag-scan ng iba. So hindi pa natin siya ma-rank. Like, versus, for example, pumasok sa criteria natin yung Adobe or AVGO. Iko-compare mo siya with Nvidia in terms of reward to risk, volume, or RSI. So kung alin yung mas malakas sa kanila, yun yung pa-prioritize mo. Yun yung pa-prioritize mo in entering. Diba? So may ranking rules ka. Next is risk management. So okay, 0.5% to 1%. So let's say meron kang $95,000 dito. So for example, ito. Yan. For example, $95,000. Lalagay mo dyan. Actually, this is an example of a second brain din. You're using a tool ni TradingView, no? You're using the long position tool para makuha mo yung quantity of stocks on this trade plan. So, may entry price ka, cut loss, and take profit levels. So, it gives out 14 shares. Yan yung ne-require niya. 14 shares for a $95,000 account size. So, 0.5% risk in terms of USD is a $475 risk. Kumbaga. Ganon. $475 risk for a 0.5%. So, 14. So, generate na tayong trade idea. So, for example, Nvidia. I-enter natin siya. Buy and then execution rules natin. Pre-market buy plus the bracket orders. Then strictly, close your position at stop loss and TP only. So for example, yan, 14, lagay mo, gawin na nating stop limit siya, no? Kasi buy on breakout. Stop limit mo at 471. 471, 43, lagay na natin dyan. Then good till cancel. Attach a bracket order. So end-to-end ko siya pinapakita sa inyo para mas ma-appreciate ninyo. Yan, 438.62. Then, click submit. Stop limit, double check. Limit prices, quantity, 14. Then, let's click submit. Yan, double check, 6,000 yung value niya. Then, override and transmit. Yan. So, nandiyan na yung Nvidia order natin. So, natapos yung end-to-end process like around 10 to 15 minutes, no? Ganun. In just one stock. So, ang tagal. Cancel ko na to.
All canceled.
Ang tagal. So, yun. Ganun yung grunt work. Matagal. Kung hindi ka gagamit ng tools. Diba? Plus, medyo ano ka pa, pwedeng makaligtaan mo yung volume, makaligtaan mo yung price relative to MA200, yung mga ganong klaseng nitty-gritty, di ba? Hindi mo siya makontrol din, actually. Kasi yun nga, human limitations. So now let's do this using a second brain tool. Using the BTP dashboard or or FinVis Elite. So smart work yung gagawin natin.